Hi, fans, and welcome to this Week 5 edition of the Woodland Hills Football Network pregame show. Last Friday, the Wolverines took on the Baldwin Highlanders at the Wolverina and shut out Baldwin 25-0. This week, Woodland Hills hits the road again as they'll travel to Upper St. Clair to take on the Panthers in a Southeastern Conference matchup. We're going to sit down with Woodland Hills head coach George Novak to review last week's victory over Baldwin. We'll take a look at this week's game against Upper St. Clair, and we'll also let you see highlights of last Friday night's game. All of that and more on the pregame show here on the Woodland Hills Football Network. The Wolverines entered week 4 3-0 after rolling over Shaler 47-14 in their home opener. The Woodland Hills offense dominated the Titans, racking up over 450 yards on the ground, including three 100-yard rushers. Woody High returned to Southeastern Conference action as they welcomed the Baldwin Highlanders to the Wolverina. Altavilla in the shotgun, sidecar to his right, he's pressured, he's hit. Looked like the ball may have squeaked loose, but Altavilla was able to hang onto it with a strong right hand. Handoff, Miles Sanders driving his way forward, good balance, near boundary, 50, 45, 40, cut back with blockers, 35, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, end zone. What great open field vision by Miles Sanders, and the Wolverines strike very quickly, and it's Miles Sanders to the house. And now a motion man is our Tompkins as he'll take the end around on the jet sweep. Tompkins steps forward, cut back, spin to the 50, and it's a first down for the Wolverines into Highlanders territory at the 49. Hand off, Joe Elshaw hesitates, now powers his way forward inside of the 30, the 25, and out of bounds along the far boundary. Two receivers to the right, double tight end formation. Jones pass complete to Tompkins. He bobbles but hangs on inside of the 20, inside of the 15, where he will step out of bounds. Altavilla is pressured as he runs to his right. He'll dump it off across the middle. The pass is complete to Vincent Perschetti. He'll run to the near side left. And Altavilla is met by a trio of Wolverines. Akira McClay, the first one there. And Will Fletcher cleans it up alongside of Laquan Bowden. And Altavilla in the shotgun. Looks right, throws right. The pass is complete. Taking a licking but holding on to the football was Vincent Perschetti. Handoff goes away from the motion. It's Sanders into open field, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 15, 10, 5, end zone. No flags, touchdown Wolverines. Altavilla looks left, throws left, the pass is complete to his brother Nick Altavilla, and a great open field tackle there by Art Tompkins as he just dumps Nick Altavilla on his hand for a loss of one. Sidecar to the left of Altavilla. He's pressured as he rolls to the near side right. Looks across the middle and diving and making the catch is Brandon Schleicher. Snap high, Doug Altavilla off of play action. Looks across the middle and the pass is complete. A leaping catch is the tight end, Josh Zinsmeister, and Zinsmeister bouncing off of black jerseys, and he'll finally be brought down inside of the Woodland Hills 20 at the 19. Altavilla in the empty set, looks to his right, he'll be hit, he escapes McVay, but now he'll be banged around, and McLean, McVay, and Damon Johnson make the tackle for the Wolverines. And loss of four on that play, as Altavilla is pressured, runs to his left, he'll be hit by Solomon, and then a trio of Wolverines coming and clean it up, again McVay involved. Jones looks to the near side left. Miles Sanders catches the football, gets a nice open field block by Stephon Hawthorne, and Sanders is brought down after picking up a first down at the 46-yard line. And Jones will throw this time to Tompkins to the right-hand side. 50, 40, eluding tacklers, and he'll finally be brought down at the 31-yard line. A huge pickup there on the screen pass to Art Tompkins. Hand off to Joe Elshaw, huge hole inside of the 40. He'll run through a Highlander and he'll be brought down at the 38-yard line. Two receivers to the right of the formation, low snap to Doug Altavilla. He'll be hit, he'll be wrapped, and he will be sacked by Amon Baldwin Youngblood. Hawthorne in the near boundary left. Rolling to the right is Jones. He'll direct traffic, he'll step into one. Coming down the near side into triple coverage. Damon Dunn comes down with it at the 11-yard line. There were three white jerseys there, but Dunn comes down with it. As Jeremiah Jones threw it down the field. Now Jones
Great drop back. Now he'll tuck and run inside of the 10, dancing inside of the 5. Dives forward into the end zone for a Woodland Hills touchdown. And yet again, late in quarter number 2, it is Jeremiah Jones being a magician. Altavilla, pressure, bounces off of a lineman, and then is brought down from behind by Akira McLean. And McLean with a punctuation mark. Motion man from right to left. Instead, the handoff will go to Sanders. Running right, cutting back left, leaps over. A Highlander now cutting it to the far boundary. Inside of the 35 as he dives to the 32-yard line. And again, the full repertoire in a run for Miles Sanders. Jones is going to run the quarterback draw. Inside of the 25, near boundary. Inside of the 20, shoved out of bounds. Hard count by Altavilla. He'll run off of play action. He's pressured as he rolls to his right. Steps up, thinks about stepping forward, but he'll be brought down by Jahad Brown. Altavilla looks right. The ball is batted to the turf by Akira McLean. Pistol formation. Jones looks to his right, throws to his right. Again, a completed screen pass to Art Tompkins, and that's enough for a Woodland Hills first down. Art Tompkins across the 45 to the 47-yard line. Pass to Art Tompkins to the near side, and Tompkins running to the near boundary, escaping Baldwin Highlanders inside of the 40. Beautiful cut to the 30. Far side, 25, 20, 15. Jeremiah Jones down there to block. Art Tompkins dives. It's a Woodland Hills TD. Altavilla on the screen. It's batted to the turf again by Akira McLean. That's his second PBU of the evening. Altavilla rolling near side, pressured by McVay. He'll throw it out into the flat. The pass is completed to Persichetti, Vincent Persichetti on the reception. 165 in the air for Altavilla as he's pressured, he's hit, he's banged around and brought down. Will Fletcher in there as well as Big Danny Gibson. As Altavilla is gonna be wrapped and he is gonna be sacked by William Fletcher. Run the end around to Tompkins to the far sideline. Big Dan Gibson leads the way. Stiff arm by Tompkins, bursts forward, and he'll be brought down at the 50-yard line. Handoff, Hassan Ghanem runs to his left, drives his way through a Baldwin Highlander. It's a Wolverine first down. Sanders, who will hand off to Sean. Now Miles is gonna keep it himself, running to the left. Inside of the 40, inside of the 35. Still on his feet, and he'll be brought down at the 33-yard line.
Nearly 200 yards and 2 touchdowns from Miles Sanders, the return of Art Tompkins, and a dominant performance from the defensive line led to the Wolverines' 25-point victory over the Baldwin Highlanders. Woodland Hills will travel to Upper St. Clair to take on the Panthers in a Southeastern Conference matchup in Week 5.
We are the Woodland Hills Wolverines. Since 1987, we've been a part of some of the most electrifying football games in Western Pennsylvania. And we've established a national reputation of excellence. Whether you're a former player, a Woody High alum, a parent, or a fan, you're part of our Wolverine family. And now you can join us by becoming a part of our new booster club, the Wolverine Nation. Visit WHFBA.org and see how your donation can help our student athletes while earning you unique benefits. We're more than just a booster club. We are the Wolverine Nation.
Hi, fans, and welcome to this Week 5 edition of the Woodland Hills Football Network pregame show. Adam Gusky here sitting down with Woodland Hills head coach George Novak. And Coach Novak, before we talk about this week's game at Upper St. Clair, let's take a look to last Friday night's game, the victory over Baldwin at the Wolverina. First of all, a very complete football game. Other than some play in the secondary, you really dominated the Highlanders.
Yeah, I was real proud of the way the boys played Friday night against Baldwin. You know, we got better offensively. We did some things I thought were a lot better. The line's starting to pick up some schemes and do the right things. Defensively, up front, we played very well. And we had a solid game. And played against, I thought, a pretty competitive Baldwin team. And I think, you know, they got some good athletes, outstanding quarterback, some big linemen. You know, the 168 boy, he's going to Penn State. He's a good player. He did a nice job pass blocking this year. So it was a very competitive game, and you know, we made some mistakes, but you know, we kept improving, and that's the main thing.
Let's talk about some specifics, and we'll start off with Miles Sanders, by far his most breakout game of the season.
Miles is just an outstanding rusher. I mean, he's an outstanding kid. has great speed, great vision, and you know, he had great moves and showed some of his strength as he broke a few tackles in his runs, and he just, you know, he did a nice job.
Jeremiah Jones seems to be getting more and more comfortable with the offense, and not just running the football, but he's throwing the ball better and making better decisions.
One thing we have to do to beat the better teams is to throw the ball a little bit better, and we're improving every week with that. The line pass blocking is getting better, and Jeremiah is reading the secondary better, and you know, he's made some nice runs when he's boxed in and gotten us out of trouble a couple times and threw a couple nice passes.
Never seems like he gets rattled, both against Shaler and against Baldwin. He came up very big late in the second quarter.
Yeah, he did. He's improving every week.
Let's talk a little bit about Art Tompkins. I'm sure you're glad to have him back in the lineup.
Art's, you know, he's like the ever-ready bunny. He goes wherever we need him, you know. We used him at safety the first couple games. Last week we used him at corner. He's a slot back. He's a running back. He returns kicks. You know, and he has a lot of energy and he has a lot of great speed. He made one of the best runs this year so far on the one quick pass he caught in the flat, made a couple moves, broke a couple tackles, cut across field, dove into the end zone. I think it was about a 50-yard play, but he ran about 150 yards. He has great athleticism, great speed, and great hands.
How about Jamon Dunn, 2 weeks in a row, big catches?
Jamon was in the crowd, and, you know, Jeremiah had pressure, and he threw it up, and, you know, Jamon came down with the play. It was a big play for us.
You touched on the defensive line and how well they played up front. Let's talk some specifics about that. First of all, to have seven players that you can rotate like that has to be a bonus.
Some of the offensive linemen play both offense and defense. Danny Gibson's one, Wolford Clark, and Amon Baldwin Youngblood. All three of them play on the offensive line, and they rotate on the defensive line. And Kevin Sullivan, he's a third-year starter at our inside tackle position. He does a great job there. Kyra McLean had a great game, and probably his best game of the year, Will Fletcher had coming off the edge, did a great job at end. Yeah, Adam McVay also had a great game for us, rushing a passer.
Coach, you touched on it a little bit early on, but it seems like the secondary is having a little bit of a struggle over the past couple weeks, both against Shaler and against Baldwin. It's not come back to haunt you by any stretch of the imagination, but it seems like you're still trying to plug in the right pieces there.
We've made some adjustments in the secondary, and a couple guys missed assignments. A couple of times they just made great play. We had guys in position. The ball was perfectly thrown. The guys made great catches. Three or four times. I think he was under 500 passing. I think he was 17 of 35, so they threw the ball a lot, but you know, they didn't complete half of them. And I'd say seven or eight of those catches were just great catches and great passes. That, you know, just no matter, we had the coverage, they just made the play.
Coach, let's get back to that offensive line. They really gave Jeremiah Jones some time, and they opened some huge holes for Miles Sanders and Joel Shaw.
The offensive line, probably the toughest position to play on the field because, you know, defenses move around so much and stunt so much, just picking everything up and learning your blocking schemes against different fronts and different stunts. And they've improved every week, and that's probably the toughest job to do for the linemen. And they don't get as much credit. And, you know, this week they made a big step. I thought they did a really nice job. Actually, last couple weeks they did, but this week, one guy stuck out a lot, and that's Wolford Clark. You're familiar with the pancake block. I think he had five or six pancake blocks in one game, and that's a lot of pancake blocks. And Coach Tim Boster, our line coach, he told him that if he got four or five pancake blocks, that he was going to buy him some wings on Wednesday, Wolverine wing night on Wednesday, so he owes him some wings this week.
Coach, let's talk about the Upper St. Clair Panthers, obviously having a bit of a down year, but still always a tough test, especially on the road.
Coach Render, he's the winningest coach in the WPIO, and, you know, by far, and I have a lot of respect for him. I think X's and O's, offense and defense, he's one of the smartest guys, maybe the smartest guy. Might be one of the older guys, he's older than me, but he's very, very good. Very good coach, and you know, his kids are well prepared every week. And this year, coming in last year, he had mostly all seniors. So this year was a new team for him. he has nice size up front, you know, quite a few, four or five guys, 280, 290. So we got a new quarterback, a couple big running backs, big defensive line, nice size linebacker. So I think they're going to get better as the season goes on. I'd rather play them early in the year, first game. But, you know, they've improved every week, and they're getting used to their system. And they play some pretty good football teams and lost some tough ones. But, you know, they had some turnovers in a couple of those games that kind of helped the other team out. But, you know, that's part of it. But I think they'll be well prepared for us. I'm looking for an exciting football game.
A lot of history in this matchup, going back to 1987 all the way through last season.
It's been quite an exciting rivalry between Upper St. Clair and Woodland Hills. Some big games. One you played in 96 where they were ranked number one in the WPL, and we upset them up at their place in the mud. Late in the game we scored, and that wasn't a very happy night for him. He's kind of mellowed since that time, but you know, he does a great job with his kids, and the rivalry, I think at first he didn't know how to take us, but it's more of a friendly rivalry now.
You touched on the mud. Funny how they got AstroTurf the next season.
They got AstroTurf the next season there. Hershey got AstroTurf the year after we were up there with Neshaminy. But hopefully, you know, we get a chance to go back here someday.
That would be terrific, hopefully this year. Coach, you touched on Coach Render being the winningest coach in the WPIAL. You just eclipsed a milestone. You're now third place.
I've been blessed, Adam, and you know, I've had some great kids as a coach, some great athletes. I've had a great coaching staff, and you know, just fortunate to have the wins, but you know, it's not about that for me. I'm just, you know, it's about the kids and helping them develop and be better people.
Let's get back to Upper St. Clair. What's it going to take to beat the Panthers?
We can't make a lot of mistakes because they like to capitalize on mistakes. You know, if you look back at the last two semifinal games we played them, you know, they made some mistakes and we were able to capitalize. And when we made mistakes, they were able to capitalize. They almost caught back up to us last year. But, you know, if you don't make mistakes, control the ball. You know, I think our offense is starting to move so we can run the football. But I think that'll be the key.
Coach, as we sit down to record this on Monday evening, the Jets take on the Bears, and obviously some Woodland Hills ties on both of those teams.
Yeah, you know, Ryan Mundy's with the Chicago Bears, and Darren Walls and Rontez Miles are both with the Jets. In fact, last week the New York Times called to do an article on the two of them coming from the same high school, Rontez and Darren. I haven't seen it, but it's supposed to come out tomorrow, I think. But yeah, it's kind of exciting when you have somebody playing on one team, but when you have somebody playing on both of them, it'll be exciting.
Rob Gronkowski also had kind of his comeback party yesterday for the New England Patriots.
Yeah, it was nice to see him get that touchdown, and he and Brady celebrated together, so that was kind of nice. It's nice to see Rob doing so well. We're really proud of him. I'm proud of all our boys.
Coach Novak, thanks a lot for your time. Good luck this week against the Panthers.
Thanks, Adam.
We'll be right back with more of the pregame show right after this here on the Woodland Hills Football Network.
What's for dinner on Wednesday night? Chicken wings. Come on down to Turtle Creek for Wednesday night wings at the Wolverina. Fresh, whole wings, hand-breaded and hand-tossed with four different flavors. And the best part is that all proceeds benefit the Woodland Hills football program. Wednesday night wings at the Wolverina, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. every Wednesday during the season. All right, fans, let's see where the Wolverines stand in the Southeastern Conference. And now let's take a look at the MSA Sports WPIAL Quad A Top 10 Rankings.
Again, fans, we thank you for joining us for this Week 5 edition of the Woodland Hills Football Network pregame show. If you can't travel down to Upper St. Clair, you can always tune in on our flagship radio station, AM 1550 WZUM. We'll also have live coverage on the web at woodlandhillsfootballnetwork.com. Our radio broadcast can also be heard live and archived on msasports.net. We'll have our live television coverage on Monroeville Comcast Cable Channel 13, Penn Hills Comcast Cable Channel 98, and Verizon Fios Channel 37. And don't forget, you can tune in to replays of Friday night's game on all of our television affiliates and our YouTube channel. For everybody at the Woodland Hills Football Network, I'm Adam Gusky, and we'll talk to you again next week.
This has been a presentation of the Woodland Hills Football Network. Watch us on YouTube, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and as always, visit us at woodlandhillsfootballnetwork.com.